obstinacy. It'll be as adamant or more adamant than us and will never give the correct picture. So in these circumstances, it becomes difficult for a physician, especially homeopathic physician, whose whole life depends on the history, his perceiving and his observations. Now this is a remedy which I am going to share with you today, which is going to definitely help you in your practice. So we'll just start with a basic quality. So what is what is the major problem today the world is going to face after some time is the addiction. Either it could be drugs or it could be alcohol. And as you know, it is one of the important things. Alcohol is becoming one of the most important things. I have a patient who owns a wine shop. He said, few years back, his monthly collection was 100,000 rupees. Today, his daily collection is more than 300,000. Daily collection is more than 300,000. And to my shock, he said that 40% of them are ladies. And they have a beautiful service known as home delivery. So the lady has to just call and get the delivery. And with the time, even the consumption of drugs have gone up. Drugs is something which has not been consumed recently, but it has been consumed since ages. And we are going to share with you a remedy which has been prepared, which was used by tribals for more than thousands of years old. Now, why do people use? Predominantly to escape from reality, but some who want to experience something which is different from reality and experience some dissociation from day-to-day life. The term hallucinogen is actually somewhat a misnomer, because outright visual hallucination is a rare part of overall experience. It may be in relation to sound. A trip into the world of hallucinogens can be very dangerous, but equally enthralling it is known about them. What is hallucinogen? It produces hallucinations. Okay, basically those who produce hallucination are known as hallucinogen. Hallucinations, strictly speaking, are perceptions that have no basis in reality, but they appear entirely realistic. So the person may not be experiencing it, but they feel that as if they are reality. These classes of psychoactive drug have in common that they can cause subjective changes in perception, thought. Understand this, subjective changes in perception, thought, emotion and consciousness. So at four levels, perception, thought, emotions and consciousness, it produces alterations. Unlike the psychoactive drugs such as stimulants and opioids, the hallucinogens do not merely amplify the familiar states of mind. So opioid or stimulants, they exaggerate the familiar state of mind, but they induce experiences that are qualitatively different from those of ordinary consciousness. So ordinarily we may not experience, but in these remedies you will experience something totally different. And these experiences are often compared to non-ordinary forms of consciousness such as trance, meditation, conversion experiences and dreams. Okay, so it flows in a particular pattern, that trance. Trance is the highest form of experience which you can have in relation to your own body and consciousness. Second level is meditation. third level is conversation, experience, and fourth level is dream. Dreams are again like valve, you know, like pressure cooker valve. It releases a lot of your subconscious and unconscious matter. The general group of pharmacological agents, commonly known as hallucinogens, can be divided into three broad categories. One is psychedelics, second is dissociatives, third one is deliriums. Okay, so we'll go into the details of them. What are psychedelics? The word psychedelic is from ancient Greek psych, that is mind, soul, plus delos, means manifest. Visible was coined to express the idea of a drug that makes manifest hidden but real aspects of life. So one are psychedelics, which expresses your hidden real self. Okay, it is commonly applied to any drug with perception altering effect, such as LSD, psilocybin, DMT, 2CB, mescaline, all of which appear to act mainly on 5-HT2A receptors. So there are receptors to which it acts. You can go through the details. There are details available into thousands of pages about these drugs. Common herbal sources of psychedelics are psilocybin mushroom. This is a very characteristic mushroom. If you have it, it produces the same effect. Ayahuasca preparation. Now, ayahuasca is the remedy which we are going to share today. It has got number of preparation, but we are going to discuss the one which has been proved. Peyote. Peyote is a small kind of cacti which grows, or pensetro cactus, and the seeds of morning glory, Hawaiian baby wood rose. These are all the remedies which can be. Some of them have been proved in homeopathy, some of them have not been proved in homeopathy. So you have a chance to prove some more medicines. Okay. The second is dissociative. Dissociative are the drugs that reduce or block the signals to the conscious mind from other parts of the brain, typically, but not necessarily or limited to the physical senses. So it blocks or reduces the signals. This is why it is known as dissociatives. It dissociates you from the reality. Such a state of sensory deprivation can facilitate self-expression, hallucinations, and dreamlike state of mind, which may resemble some of the psychedelic state of mind. Okay, so basically it will predominantly take you to the next level. What is meditation? What is when you do the deeper meditation, you dissociate from world. For few seconds, you are not in touch with the world. You are just gone. The primary dissociatives are angel dust, include ketamine, okay, and dextromethorphan, an active ingredient for many cough syrups. So it produces, you know, sometimes when you take this, you feel like dissociated, you go to sleep. Also include a nitrous oxide, muscimol from Amanita muscaria, the fly agaric mushroom. So some of the mushroom also produces the similar effect. Or deliriants are anticholinergics. They are the special class of dissociative which are antagonists to the acetylcholine receptors. Unlike muscarine and nicotine, which are agonists of these receptors. Okay. Now, deliriums are sometimes called true hallucinogenics. These deliriums are in reality the true hallucinogenics because they do not, they